Students, now we are going to discuss phylum Mollusca. So think of certain organisms like snail, octopus, sepia, clear? So let us study what structures do they have.
So students, you can easily recognize the phyla, octopus, these are all members of phylum Mollusca. So what characters do they have? After the arthropod, they are the second largest phylum, having 60,000 species. Now they are triploblastic, bilaterally symmetrical, clear. Another important thing is they have soft unsegmented body. The Mollusca means soft unsegmented body. So their body is very soft. You can see within this shell, there is the soft unsegmented body. Now, and their body is generally covered with a calcareous shell. It is not that always the calcareous shell will be the external covering of the body. Sometimes internal shell also develop, clear, like in octopus. So, but calcareous shell, made up of calcium carbonate, will be there, and body is divided. Now the body is divided into head region. This is the visceral hump, which contains the most of the organs, vital organs, and the foot. Clear? So body has three part: head, visceral hump, and foot. And from here, a skin fold, you can see here a fine skin fold has been produced, which is called mantle. Clear? The skin fold over the body, this is called mantle. Mantle in turn secretes the shell. Clear? So just above the visceral hump contains all the visceral organs, vital organs, and above the visceral hump there is a skin fold called mantle, and mantle in turn secretes the shell. Now, if you go on for the body cavity, there is true body cavity, coelom is there, but it is highly reduced. It is only present near the heart, excretory parts, and the reproductive cavities. And other part of the body cavity, clear, contains thus most of the space is of the viscera, clear, contains the hemocell, the blood, and forms the hemocell. So most of the part of the viscera contains the blood and forms the hemocell, and the coelom is reduced only in the parts like the heart, pericardial, excretory, and reproductive cavities. Now, digestive tract, you can see here, it opens in the mouth, clear, and ends in the, it's a complete digestive tract, clear. And this mouth contains, this is very unique feature, this mouth contains a rasping organ called radula. You can see here, this is the opening of the mouth, which contains a rasping organ called radula, which contains the chitinous teeth. This radula, you can see, they contains the chitinous, very fine chitinous teeth. So this portion is the radula with the chitinous teeth. And anus opens in the mantle cavity. So complete digestive system with a rasping organ called radula in the mouth, which is provided with chitinous teeth. Clear? This rasping organ helps in the, it may, for, clear? So it helps to rasp the food into small particles. Now, respiration is by gills, which are present in this, this is the mantle cavity, this is the mantle, and this is the mantle cavity. Respiration by gills, when they are aquatic, clear, they respire through gills, which are present in the mantle cavity, and it is also called tinidia, but they also have the pulmonary sac, clear, or air sac, lungs or air sac. by which they respire in the terrestrial condition, when they are in the terrestrial land. Now, circulatory system, it is open type. Now, just before this, in annelida, we have learned closed type of circulatory system, but here the circulatory system is open type, clear, and only in few like octopus and all, they have the closed type of circulatory system, but otherwise, generally they have open type of circulatory system. And another thing is the blood. Blood contains the respiratory pigment, which is copper containing respiratory pigment, which is called hemocyanin. So copper containing blue respiratory pigment called hemocyanin. Now, excretory organ is the kidney, which is also called organ of Bujanas, which also opens in the mantle cavity. Excretory organ is kidney, which is also called organ of Bujanas and opens in the mantle cavity. It may have this, some of them which are aquatic, they have, they are amniotic, but ureotelic. Terrestrial mollusks are also ureotelic. Now, nervous system is pair of ganglia with joined by commissures. Sense organ includes eyes. You can see here the eyes clear. They have tentacles. Clear the tentacles, eyes. They have statuses for equilibrium. And another unique is the Ospreidia, which is, they have the sense organ called Ospreidia, which is mainly responsible for testing the chemical and physical nature of the water. So Ospreidia is there for testing chemical and physical nature of the water. If you go on for the reproduction, we'll find the sexes are separate. Fertilization may be internal or external. Most of them are oviparous. They lay eggs. Have you seen the eggs of the snail? And their development is indirect, maybe direct or indirect through the larva cell, like Golygium or Veligal larva. Clear? And examples, we know that Pila is one of the most important. So there are various examples like Pila, apple snail, pink tada, this oyster. So it's very important that oyster pearl, they are produced by this phylum. Clear? Pearl oyster, sepia, which is called cuttlefish, loligo squid, you know, giant squid. So this loligo, they are under this group. Now, octopus, which is commonly called devilfish, as aplysia, that you see here, dentalium, tusk shell, and so on. So they have lots of, and economically, you know, pearl is produced by this group, so they are important. And some unique feature is the body is soft. Some unique feature of this group is soft body containing head, visceral mass and foot, glandular fold of fold called mantle over the body, and mantle secretes calcareous cell around the body, and rasping organ, that presence of radula as the rasping organ. So these are the general feature. And a question may arise, they have open type of circulatory system and they don't have hemoglobin. Now, how they are advanced over the annelida? They have distinct head and much better sense organs and gills or lungs for respiration. How they are more advanced than that of the annelida?